A very good morning, students. I hope you are doing well and be regular in your classes. So today we have another video of our running chapter, Changes Around Us. So today we are going to study our new topics, but let's revise what we have learned in our previous video. So in previous video we have discussed about general changes that happens around us. Okay, like reversible changes, irreversible changes, there are examples like milk will convert into curd and folding of paper, stretching of rubber band and glowing off your electric bulb and switch off that electric bulb, cooking of food, respiration, digestion, etc. And we had to find that difference between the your reversible changes, irreversible changes, physical changes, chemical changes, etc. So today we are going to discuss about the two types of changes, that reversible change and irreversible change. As you already know and you are very familiar about these two terms, what is reversible changes and irreversible changes. So reversible changes, a change that can be reversed by changing its condition, or you can say a change that can be bring back to its original position, shape or size is called reversible change. For example, and the best example is ice to water and water to ice. When we cool water, it will convert into the ice, and when we heat ice, it will convert into the water. Next is irreversible change, a change which cannot be brought back to its original position, shape or size even by changing their conditions. Okay, so that change is known as irreversible change. As you can see the given example, that we have a egg. If we fry that egg, it will convert into the omelette. But omelette cannot reverse into their original shape or raw egg. And another one is, you can say there is a flour dough, and by the processing of baking, it will convert into the bread. But we cannot reverse that baked bread into the raw dough. So these are about the introduction of your reversible change and reversible change that we have already studied in our keyword. Here are some more examples of reversible and irreversible changes. Firstly, we will take about the reversible changes example. First, drying of wet cloth. After washing of cloth, by the process of evaporation, clothes will get dried, but we can again wet them. So that is reversible change. Next is glowing of an electric bulb. Next, when we mix a salt into the water, it will make salt solution, but we can separate salt from the water with the help of heating, or you can say evaporation. By the help of the evaporation, the water will be evaporated in the form of vapor and salt will left behind. Next is, we will take irreversible changes examples. First, cooking of food. If we cooked a food, so all the raw vegetables will convert their compositions into the another form. They will become eatable, or you can say soft in nature. So we cannot turn that cooked food into the raw vegetables. Next is, burning is a non-reversible change. Yes, so as you can say, the burning of matchsticks. So we cannot turn the ashes of burnt matchstick into the complete or original matchstick. And the last one is your baking of cake from the dough. So we cannot reverse back that cake into the raw dough. Let's come on to the next topic, that is physical change. What is physical change? A change in which only the physical properties, or you can say the outer appearance of a substance, get changed and no new substance is formed. So here are a lot of examples, that cutting of an apple which change the shape or the structure of the apple by cutting it. So that is in physical change. Broken pencil, because broken pencil will not convert into the another object. It will remain same, but the shape or size of the broken pencil will be changed. Next is cutting of paper. Compressing of can and cutting of vegetables are the example of physical change. So students, always keep in your mind, physical change and reversible change are relatively same. Next is chemical change. What is chemical change? A change in which composition of reacting substances get changed and cannot be reversed back. It means if you react more than two substances together, they will form a third substance, or you can say the new substance. And we cannot change that new formed substance into their reactant. So here are some examples like decaying of fruits and veggies, burning of candles, making bread from dough, toaster, coffee maker, and another examples are respiration, digestion, transportation, and so many things. So students, these are the examples of chemical change. So that's all for today, and we have completed our sixth chapter with our second video. Thank you.